Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website, that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for May the 5th of 2020, well, it is titled Carina in Perspective. So what do we see here? Well, we see a number of different things in the sky, starting looking right above the tree in the foreground. We can see the Carina Nebula, and this is a great star-forming region, well known for a special star that's located within it named Eta Carinae. And that star is a very unusual star and changes in brightness, and a very unstable star. And in fact, sometimes it becomes one of the brightest stars in the sky, and other times it is just an ordinary star. And it is likely the type of star that we expect would eventually become a supernova and will explode, giving a very bright, bright star that would be visible easily during the day. So that is something that will happen, and astronomers believe that will happen sometime in the near future. But whether near future could very easily be next year or 1,000 years from now, as both would be very, very quick, astronomically speaking. Now up above that, and slightly to the left, is the Running Chicken Nebula, which is another example of a what we call an emission nebula, like the Carina Nebula in the star-forming region. Lot of glowing hydrogen gas, which makes up the red color of both of these. And above that, we see the Southern Cross, four bright stars in the shape of a cross, three blue stars, very hot stars towards the left, and one red star, much cooler star, towards the right. So as we've learned, the color of a star tells us something about its temperature. The hotter the star, the more high energy light it will emit. And blue light is a shorter wavelength and a higher energy than red light. So stars that appear blue are much hotter than stars that appear red. So we can tell there are two distinct temperatures here, three stars that are very hot and one star that is very cool. And then finally, we see up next to the Southern Cross, just to the left of it, is the Coalsack Nebula, a dark nebula, which is, again, a region of star formation, but a darker region and at an earlier stage of star formation than the other ones that we looked at down below. And that is because the dust here is still too dense for us to be able to see through. So the darker areas are very difficult to see through in visible light because there is so much material there that it blocks out the light that would come through that would be behind it. And eventually, over hundreds of thousands of years, then the stars that are beginning to form right now will eventually emerge out of the Coalsack and will then become visible. And it will turn what we see as a dark nebula in the Coalsack into more of an emission nebula like the other nebulae that we looked at earlier here. So the two down below, the Running Chicken Nebula and the Carina Nebula, are already beginning to glow as the hot stars have emerged from their darker areas and now illuminate that light, cause it to glow. That will eventually happen to the Coalsack Nebula, but not this year or next or even 1,000 years from now. We'll begin to see that over hundreds of thousands of years as the stars that are just beginning to form finish that process. So that was our picture of the day for May the 5th of 2020. It was titled Carina in Perspective. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be Star Parabola. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.